2012 edition is being introduced to the crowd on hand. Their opponent tonight, Tunisia. That's right, Tunisia. This is their first trip to the Olympics in basketball. They qualified for the African Championship, winning their first African Championship over Angola. Angola's used to coming to the Olympics. Tunisia isn't. This is a great experience for them. They started off very slowly in their opener against Nigeria. They trailed at the half by 16, but they shut Nigeria down in the second half, only to fall short at the end, losing 60-56. You're looking at the players as they're being introduced. Their starters, point guard Marwan Keshred, he'll be wearing number 8. Forward number 4, Radwan Sliman. Power forward number 12, Makram Ben Ramadan. The captain of the team, number 13, did not start the opener, but he's the best player they have. That's Amin Erzig. The other starter, Salah Mejri, he's the big fella, 2 meters, 16, 7'1". That's the coach, Adel Talatli, who has coached for 12 years the Tunisia Olympic squad in preparation for this, the national team. And the other starter, Nizar Kineoa, number 6. That, of course, the national anthem of the USA. And next, we'll hear the national anthem from Tunisia. And the two teams will shake hands and get ready to do battle. In this division, this is Group A, the United States, Argentina, Lithuania, and France rated the top 4 teams, followed by Nigeria and Tunisia. In Group B, the top teams, Russia, Spain, Brazil. After that, it's anyone's guess who's going to be the 4th best team here, the way we've watched them so far, Australia, Great Britain, or China. It'll be 4 teams from each side making it into the quarterfinals. So these are how they get seeded, these qualification games. USA is coached by what is widely thought the best coach America has produced in a long, long time, Mike Krzyzewski. He is the winningest collegiate coach, university level, that the United States has ever had. He coaches a team called Duke University, and he's been involved with USA basketball for a long, long time. He's also been inducted into the Hall of Fame. You can see the standings from Group A on your screen. Very even. Whoever wins this game tonight, if it's the United States, they'll be the only undefeated team left in this group. Tunisia needs a win, and then the whole group will be tied up. The odds makers would give you better odds that Tunisia would score more points than the USA would have slam dunks tonight than they would give you for Tunisia actually winning this game. That's how big a favorite the U.S. is. But we'll have to wait and see. Either way, it should be a high-flying affair. You should see a lot of dunks, a lot of all-star type plays in this one because it's full of all-stars. The U.S. opened with a scare in the first quarter against France. They were playing pretty even, but then pulled away after that. They called it a slow start. It looked pretty good, but they beat France 98-71. The U.S. team just too short of 100. You can see their starting lineup. At center, Tyson Chandler, the only center that is not a university player on this lineup due to a lot of injuries. The big center, Dwight Howard, didn't make it. At forward, Kevin Durant and LeBron James, arguably the best player in the world today, and a guard, Kobe Bryant and Chris Paul. For Tunisia, they've thrown us a little bit of the curve. They have changed their starting lineup from the first game, so they will play their best player and their captain and let him have at it in this game, Amin Irzik. For those of you that aren't familiar with U.S. basketball, just figuring out how to pronounce the coach's name, looking at the spelling, is a contest in itself. So if you have a pen, I'll let you write this down. K-R-Z-Y-Z is how it starts. K-R-Z-Y-Z, then a vowel, E-W-S-K-I. It looks like Krzyzewski, but it's pronounced Krzyzewski. And get used to it because you'll be hearing his name for a long time. That's Kevin Durant, one of the younger stars in the NBA. Led Oklahoma City into the finals this year. In fact, three of his teammates are on this team, Russell Westbrook and James Harden. They lost the NBA championship this year to LeBron James's team, the Miami Heat. And with that, LeBron James finally wins an NBA championship. He was the best player that hadn't won one coming into this. There are two players, including LeBron James, on this club that have lost an Olympic game. They were there when they were beaten. That would be Carmelo Anthony and James. So they remember what it's like, and they swear not to let it happen again. That's Tyson Chandler. He'll be starting at center. Chandler plays for the New York Knicks of the NBA, stands 2 meters 16, 7 foot 1. He will go up against a gentleman the same size, Salah Mejri. Adel Tlotli, final words of wisdom. Quick look at Kobe Bryant, one of the international favorites. He's won 5 NBA titles. This is only his second Olympics. And that's LeBron James. James looks like he's 40 years old. He's looked that way since he was 16. He's only 27 in the prime of his career. So can Tunisia hang with them, and for how long? Odds makers aren't giving them much of a chance, but that's on paper. Let's see what happens in real life. At least they're not posing for photos like in Barcelona many years ago when the opponents posed for pictures with the original Dream Team right before the game started. And we're underway here. The announcer was letting the crowd chant down to the go time, and the referee threw the ball up with them still on number 3. Kobe Bryant from outside can't hit. Rebound by Bin Ramadan. Bin Ramadan, 12 points and 12 rebounds in the first game. That's Keshrid, and that goes off the leg of El Mabrouk. Just underway here, first quarter. This is the second day of men's basketball, and Chris Paul, widely respected as one of the top point guards in the world, will be leading the USA attack. And that's Kobe Bryant, who seems to be able to hang in the air forever. That puts the U.S. on the board. Oddsmakers predict that the U.S. would score somewhere between 90 and 120 points in this game. El Mabrouk gives back. Three-point basket, and Tunisia has the lead. How about that? Durant can't answer. U.S. keeps it alive. And an offensive foul scored. So Amin Erzik, with an assist to Marwan Keshrid, puts Tunisia on top. In just a moment, while they mop up the sweat off the floor. Keshrid, the point guard. Good passer. Played every minute of the game against Nigeria. Had 12 points, 4 rebounds. Mejri, the big fella. He will shoot it. Comes up a little bit short, and Chris Paul comes away with it. James, and Durant can't find it. The U.S. will look to fast break at every opportunity. That's a look at Krzyzewski, now that you know how to spell his name. Caught it a little bit too far under the basket to be able to do much with it, and Erzik just caught him with the shoulder. It was a battle between Kobe Bryant and Durant for the high scorer in the NBA this year. Durant can light it up. All these USA players play about equal playing time, so no one really puts up big individual numbers. They never have. Just underway, first quarter action. El Mabrouk. Bin Ramadan, his shot partially deflected. James comes away. Kobe Bryant, and he throws it away. Back comes Keshrit. He's got El Mabrouk on the wing, and they will slow it up. Three-pointer on the way from Erzik again. And he flags it down. Why not another one? And the U.S. very lazy trying to rebound, and they're out being out-hustled by Tunisia. And they will get an earful from their coach if they continue that. If there's one Achilles heel on this American squad this year, it is at the center position. They've traditionally been able to trot out two or three very talented big men, from Shaq to others, and they're very limited this year. Another three-pointer, Bin Ramadan scores. And Tunisia back on top again, 6-4. If it looks like the U.S. isn't into it, that's the way it looks to me, too. Bryant for three. Bin Ramadan with a nice rebound. He will take it length of the court and slam it right in their face. How about that for Tunisia? Makram Bin Ramadan, 23 years old. He doesn't care if he's playing against legends. And Keshrit to the big fella. And this time it was contested. Mejri couldn't get a hold of it. And a putback by Tyson Chandler. Chandler, one of the best defensive players in the NBA, not known for his scoring. And Ramdan, little give and go. Nice little move down the lane. Comes up a little bit strong as Keshrad had a little too much momentum. Chris Paul crosses the timeline for the U.S. And again, they look like they're sleepwalking. So Paul on the scoring column now. He was traded in the middle of the NBA season to the LA Clippers. A lot of teams were fighting for his rights, and we are tied at 8. Keshrad. Ben Ramdan a little strong that time. Durant, that's his spot. He loves that area of the floor. U.S. in a soft man-to-man defense at this point. Keshrad can't go. And Mejri knocks it out of bounds past Tyson Chandler. There's one other big man on this team. He's only 19 years old, Anthony Davis. He's the number one draft pick for the NBA out of the university level, Kentucky. And that shot rejected by the big fella, and Mejri has his first block. From the corner for 3, El Mabrouk. Tunisia back in the lead. And I think Coach Mike Krzyzewski's seen about enough. He's going to yank almost every one of these players off the court in a minute. Kobe Bryant, nice little spin moves. You can see his quickness there. They have played zero defense so far. And Durant just loses it going up. Ben Ramdan, nice lead pass on the basket by Irzig. Nice to see the way Tunisia is playing. Great team basketball, 13-12. Much better start than they had, believe it or not, against Nigeria. They had 21 turnovers against Nigeria's defense, and I think they only have 2 tonight. That's Bryant. Ben Ramdan comes away with it. Like the way the big guy runs the court. Chandler with the rebound. Durant, he's deadly. And another rebound from Ben Ramdan. He's got 5 points, 4 rebounds, and 2 assists already. What a night. Irzig can't find the range. And here comes Bryant. 1-on-4. Durant's not bashful, that's one thing for sure. Mejri with the rebound. So the U.S. didn't have much of a lead at all in one quarter against Spain, and they may find themselves trailing at the end of this quarter against Tunisia, a team the bookmakers here in London gave no chance to even be in it. And wholesale substitutions now for the U.S. as the starters will come out. Kevin Love, number 11, now into the game for the U.S. He's the rebounding leader of the NBA. Along with Carmelo Anthony, number 15, he can play forward, guard, power forward. He can even be a point guard if he needs to. Number 9 is Andre Iguodala. 8, Deron Williams. Williams is going to play in a city that loves its sports, that hasn't had any kind of team in many years. Brooklyn, right outside of New York City. And El Mabrouk makes the first. Brooklyn, if any of you are familiar with American baseball, had a very beloved franchise for many, many years. the Brooklyn Dodgers. And when they left and moved to Los Angeles and became what are today the Los Angeles Dodgers, that whole city has been angry ever since. They've got an NBA team starting next year. And that's the guy they're going to watch, Deron Williams, who just hit that. Tunisia still by one. 2:20 to go, first quarter. El Mabrouk. Oh, he had a cutter right there. And Erzig is held by Love. That's Deron Williams. A little floater. Iguodala with a nice screen. Measuring. He can shoot three-pointers, but when you're that big, they want you near the basket. And El Mabrouk will take the outside shot. And Westbrook's pass got thrown away, but Love is there for the easy one. So Marwan Keshrid will work the offense. Tunisia now down by one, just under 2 minutes to go. First quarter. And a reach-in foul on Russell Westbrook. You can tell this other group that did not start the game for the U.S. watched the supposed first-tier superstars and how little defense they were playing and decided they wanted to try to pick up the pressure a little bit. Tunisia responding well. Adel Talatli's team, the offense that he's running with the penetration and the cutting across the top of the lane is really working. That's James Harden with the beard on the bench. So Keshrid will set the offense this time. Trying to find an open. That's been Ramadan. Backing down on Williams and the shot clock violation. Got to be aware of that 24-second shot clock. It's been reduced from 30 to 24 for this Olympics. That is the NBA shot clock. It speeds up play. You get a little bit more offense in the game. Williams kicks it out, and the three-pointer, no good by Love, and stuffed back in. That was Andre Iguodala getting in the scoring column emphatically. Keshrid's pass goes astray. And right back at you, Iguodala's pass. A little bit too much for Carmelo Anthony to handle. Westbrook, one of the quicker players in the NBA. You watch him right there. He can get to the basket in a hurry, and he draws the foul. So the foul on Marwan Keshrid. And if the game turns out like the first quarter, all the odds makers are totally wrong about this game. Some of these players, as you might imagine, with the millions and millions of dollars they make on this U.S. team, their egos are equally large. And they've been comparing themselves and saying that they're better than the original dream team from Barcelona, a team that had 11 players that ended up in the NBA Hall of Fame out of 12. Better than Michael Jordan, better than Magic Johnson, better than Larry Bird. Most Americans don't think so. Most basketball fans don't think so. And, you know, they might be able to beat that team, but you got to think that that team's 50 years old now. So Tunisia had the lead for a while. They're now down by six as Westbrook made the basket. And Keshrid will ready Tunisia to take the final shot. 7 seconds left to go in the quarter. El Mabrouk. And another shot clock violation. They were looking at the game clock and not the shot clock. Big mistake, and Talatli not happy. So just under 3 seconds left in the quarter. Westbrook, he'll get one off. And the United States of America, expected to blow Tunisia out of the gym, did not do so. A nice quarter, nice offense, and nice patience from Tunisia. At the end of one, the score, USA 21, Tunisia 15. Now, if you look at those statistics, field goal percentage, Tunisia 29%, the USA 45. Where is all this coming from Tunisia? Why are they playing so well? Well, there seems to be a lot more presence on the court. The United States very lackadaisical defensively. The U.S. also 0 for 8 from three-point range, while Tunisia has drained a few of those bombs, as you're looking at some highlights. And when Ben Ramadan came down the court early, this one, I believe it is, and slammed it right in the face of those NBA All-Stars. That was a wake-up call. Chris Paul, little guy, just over the outstretched fingers. And the shooter, Kevin Durant. He's got 4 points. So does Kobe Bryant. Westbrook with three. For Tunisia, three players with five each, El Mabrouk, Ben Ramadan, and Erzig. They have been the firepower. Nice overhead look at the basketball arena here at Olympic Park. That's Carmelo Anthony. Hasn't gotten involved much either on offense or defense so far. As Kobe Bryant watches from the bench. Some of the Tunisian fans having a really good time here. El Mabrouk will inbound the ball. And we're underway, second quarter action. The U.S. with a 6-point lead over Tunisia. This is the second day of men's basketball. The ball stolen away by the U.S. Anthony from outside, that's three. The assist to Westbrook. Keshrit off that high screen. That's the play that they've been most effective with. Nice lob pass down low. And defensively it was blocked from behind. Ben Ramadan looked like he was going to go dunk it. Westbrook pulls up for a quick one. And I think Adel Tlatli is going to want a timeout here. And they do call a timeout. The USA now up 26-15. And let's see if we can get an inside look at the huddle. See if we can get a camera in there close to Coach Krzyzewski. And the microphone is with the Tunisian team. See, they're talking about setting that high screen and cutting off of it. They were setting the screen at the top of the key and then just doing a traditional, what they call a pick and then roll, and finding the U.S. defense very soft early. This group has figured that out. Perfect form from Russell Westbrook. There's three cameras mounted behind the basket. And Erzig being pressed in the backcourt, the first time the U.S. has had full court pressure, but it was a little tentative. And Mohamed Hadidan is now in for Tunisia. He's number 9. Oh, look what I got. Ben Ramadan receives the benefit of the I'm going out of bounds here, catch it pass from the U.S. player. And Ben Ramadan with 7. Westbrook, Anthony, he likes to shoot. And robbed up back out to Keshrit. And slapped away by Anthony. Shot clock down to 8. And the ball goes out of bounds. Williams decides to work off that top screen set by Iguodala. Comes up a little short but draws the foul. The foot speed that Russell Westbrook has is rarely matched. So the three from Oklahoma City, Harden, Westbrook, and Durant. They've got that city very excited. And they're all pretty young. They have another shot at an NBA championship when next year rolls around. But LeBron James finally got one. Is now 12. U.S. pressing in the backcourt. Nice lead pass down low, and whoops! Mejri wanted the foul, and that'll technically a jump ball called when the ball gets stuck like that. You don't see it often. Challenged by James and just couldn't get it over the rim. Salah Mejri at 2 meters 16, 7 foot one, shouldn't have had any trouble getting it over that rim. Durant, look at that touch pass back at him and then block the other way. Mejri goes down. Ben Ramadan will reset. He and Keshrit have pretty good rhythm together. There's that top screen. Now you're supposed to roll to the basket. He had him for a second. He flashed open. Keshrit for 3. Good. That's where the lack of size for the American team is pretty evident. Keshrit, he take it again. And just like that, they've cut the lead to 6. Anthony shot, no good. Challenged by Mejri, who will pick up the foul. Take a look at Keshrit in action. Marwan scored 11 points a game in the African Championships. Again, he's played every minute of the Olympic basketball experience so far. He's 31 years old, just 1 meter 7'6", or 5'9", had 12 points in the first game. And he's got a couple three-pointers and 6 as Mejri goes out with 3 fouls, and that's big because he is the size for Tunisia. Ben Ramadan is 2 meters 4, 6'8". So they lose a lot when Mejri sits down. That young lady got all painted up for this one. And Carmelo Anthony to the free throw line. And he makes them both. So the lead is back up to 8. We're in the second quarter. You saw the standings earlier. This is the final game in this division. The United States looking to be undefeated after two games. If so, they will have a lead because everybody else is 1-1. And if Tunisia should lose this game, they'll have two losses. The rest of the A division, very, very equal. And Ramdan now with the foul. Fouls would be a huge problem for Tunisia. But Mejri had three. Nobody else has more than one. Hadidan gives way, and that's Giazza. Mohamed Giazza now in, and the ball stolen away by the U.S. Showtime! That is LeBron James, and that is what he does best. Nice pass. In the starting lineup, or at least some of them back in, Chris Paul number 13, Kobe Bryant number 10, LeBron James number 6. Anthony stays on the court for the U.S. And Ramdan, nice move down low and score it. Makram Ben Ramdan trying to show the NBA scouts, hey, there's a contract here. Look at me. I'm worth $10 million too. And you can see James elevate here. And Hadidan got posterized. Nice play to keep it alive by Giazza. Good look at Coach Dulatli. Tyson Chandler, the center, back in for the U.S., number 4. And that ball poked away, almost stolen by Kevin Durant. You see Chris Paul beginning to put a little more pressure on the point guard for Tunisia, Marwan Keshret. We'll see if that continues. They pretty much let Keshret do what he wanted to early and reach and foul as we talk about it. Erzig foul by Kobe Bryant. Nice offensive move to draw the foul. That was Hadidan down low. He's a rebounder. Power forward, 2 meters five or 6 foot nine. Nice move. You see a lot of the U.S. players smiling, laughing. You don't see that when they're in a competitive game. That's three fouls on Bryant already. Now, unlike Tunisia, the U.S. really doesn't lose a lot when a player, even the caliber of Kobe Bryant, goes to the bench. So into the game for the first time, James Harden. He's got the longest beard in the NBA. 33-25. U.S. up by 8, 5:26 left to go in this first half. Hadidan had a chance to cut that lead down and missed them both. Good defense being played by Tunisia. And the three-pointer from Harden does not fall. So let's see if Tunisia can close the gap again. What a beautiful pass, and Keshwood couldn't get the rebound, but Tunisia keeps it alive. Oh, what a great pass down low to Ben Ramdan. He's got 11 now. What an assist. Erzig, beautiful pass. And that's the first bucket for Harden in this game. A lot of one-on-one being played by the Americans. You don't see them calling many plays. Just relying on athletic ability. That won't happen in games against Spain and Argentina. You'll see a lot more strategy. Tonight, the coach just feels content to just let him go. Harden crosses the timeline and throws it away. And you can see Krzyzewski's not happy. He's one of the few coaches that's not afraid to get in the face of multimillionaires and tell them what he really thinks of how they're playing. Herzig will get a welcomed rest. He's played well. What a pass a minute ago. Very impressed with Makram Ben Ramdan. Can Keshrid make another one? He does. And it's a five-point game. 3:27 left to go in this second quarter. Tyson Chandler gets the easy one. Well, if this is any measure of whether this team that the U.S. is fielding is as good as the 92 Barcelona Dream Team, They didn't let anybody get anywhere near close. Now, the world has closed the gap quite a bit in basketball since then, but still, there's no contest. Nice move by Harden. And we've got a timeout with 2:43 left to play here in the first half of action. The United States on top of Tunisia, 39-30. As you look into the huddle of Tunisia, I can tell you that once again they're shooting well. 6 of 13 this quarter, 46%, 37% for the game. The U.S. has a rebounding advantage of 20-15. Tunisia blocked a couple of the U.S. shots. Not much difference except a few extra follow-up shots by the USA, but the Americans hitting 53% of their shots. They've each taken 30. The U.S. has made five more, and that's the lead. Keshrid's done his part. The little point guard, Amin Keshrid. He's the captain, 32 years old. And he and Herzig, the veterans of this. I owe him an apology. He's only 31 years old. Erzig's the old man at 32. Ben Ramadan with it. And you see the U.S. trying to keep the ball out of Keshridge's hands. Hadidan back out. Shot clock coming down. They don't have much time. 6 seconds. It was a creative shot by Hadidan. And Chris Paul will set the offense, and Durant will fire. Kevin Durant with 7. And the lead had been cut to 5, is back up to a dozen. Radwan Sliman back into the game, number 4 for Tunisia. He started the first game, did not start tonight. Keshrid doesn't have a shot there, and the shot clock, I believe, expired. 1:43 left to go in this first half. You notice the crowd's somewhat sleepy as well. They expected a up-and-down dazzling display of basketball by the Americans, and they're quite frankly not getting it. Now, that was a pretty good bit of passing from Fall to James, and then a quick touch pass right to Tyson Chandler. Watch James just quickly throw it right back to Chandler. He gets a player up in the air and then score the basket, and he'll go to the free throw line. Well, the foul occurred way before he took the shot. Mohamed Ghiazza said, come on, are you kidding? I only hit him a little bit. So another rebound for Ben Ramadan, and last time he did this, he came down and jammed it. This time he draws a foul against Chandler. U.S. up by a dozen, 1:26 left to go first half. Argentina, Lithuania, France, and Nigeria all one win, one loss in this division. And on the B, as they showed you earlier, Russia, Spain, and Brazil both undefeated with two wins. Australia, Great Britain, and China have yet to win a game. Great game so far by Makram. So Harden will reset, 10 seconds on the shot clock. James and Chris Paul will get the open three. Can't find it. And Ghiazza with it. And nobody was looking for that pass. Here come the Americans, 4-on-1, little behind the back, dipsy doodle action. Kevin Durant, the beneficiary, and gets the two. Sleeman throws back up top. Keshrid. Mawa. Aleph Mawa. And that'll be three. So there's about 25 seconds left to go, and Tunisia still hanging around here. Two teams qualified from Africa this year. Nigeria and Tunisia. 8 seconds on the game clock, and an offensive foul against USA. They're not going to get any sympathy from an international group of officials. It's not the NBA where superstars can get away with just about everything, even though there's a little bit of acting there. There's that behind-the-back pass from LeBron James to the easy basket for Kevin Durant. And you can understand that in any language. Just a hair under 6 seconds left to go in this first half. And if you notice the graphic a minute ago, Chris Paul now with three fouls, he and Kobe Bryant both. An Olympic effort by the MOP crew thus far. They've been on the floor as much as some of the American starters. Elma Brook inbounds. Hadidan. And no foul call. A little bit of a surprise as Mawa got hit. And that ball went in. You didn't see it on the screen, but it was just after the buzzer, so it wouldn't have counted anyway. The United States leading at half over Tunisia, 46-33. If you were expected a huge show of slam dunks and highlights, you know, you didn't get it. Tunisia played a lot better than anybody expected, and the USA came out really soft. Kevin Durant leads the Americans with 9 points. Carmelo Anthony has 7. Westbrook and Chandler each have 6. For Tunisia, Makram Ben Ramdan, 11 points. He has played brilliantly in this game, and when he took it down and slammed it on the U.S. team, he made a statement. 6 rebounds and 3 assists to go with those 11 points. Marwan Keshra, the point guard, has 9 points on 3 three-pointers. Elmer Brook has 5, Erzig has 5, and Mawa has 3. And that's all the scoring for Tunisia. United States on top, 46-33, and we will take a break and join you right before the second half starts. And welcome back to the basketball arena here at Olympic Park for preliminary round Group A game between the United States and Tunisia. If you expected the United States to win in a big blowout, you haven't seen it yet. They have a comfortable margin of 13 points, but Tunisia came to play. Led by Makram Ben Ramadan, 11 points, 6 rebounds, and 3 assists, including a slam dunk over some of the U.S. premier players in the first half. He's led them. Marwan Keshgrid, the point guard, led them to the African Championships. He's been on fire, running the offense beautifully. Has 3 three-pointers. He has 9 points. El Mabrouk, 5 points. Erzig, 5 points. And Mawa has 3. For the United States, they've been led by Kevin Durant with 9. Carmelo Anthony has 7. Russell Westbrook, 6. Tyson Chandler, 6. Where are the big names in the scoring? Not a lot. LeBron James, 2. Kobe Bryant, 4. The Americans, you can't blame them for not coming out really fired up. They weren't expected to get much of a battle here. But if Tunisia had played with this level of intensity in their opening game against Nigeria, it wouldn't have been close. They were down at half by 16 points, only to rally, had a chance to win at the end, and fell to Nigeria as Nigeria held on. But the level of play that they're displaying today is head and shoulders better than they played in that game. You would expect Tunisia to get fired up to take on a team considered by many one of the greatest ever assembled. You would also think that the United States would play with a little bit more passion, intensity, and pride than they have displayed so far in this game. See if Mike Krzyzewski makes any changes to the starting lineup for the U.S. There's a look at Adil Talatli. And it looks like Carmelo Anthony is going to start. He came off the bench for the United States, and I saw Kevin Love with his warm-up. There is Love. So he didn't start the game. He's going to start the second half. For Tunisia, that's Alif Maua, number 10. Getting a start because Salah Mejri is on the bench with 3 fouls to start this half. So as Radwan Sliman inbounds the ball, we begin half number 2 here from the basketball arena at Olympic Park. Tunisia trying to cut into a 13-point lead from Team USA. Second day of men's basketball. Mawa has it stripped away from behind, and that's Love with the outbreak pass to Westbrook, and he is fouled. Score the basket. So the subs that Mike Krzyzewski put in the first half are starting the second half. And there's that chest, that quickness. You cannot stop Russell Westbrook. And a reach-in foul from Keshrit. So Westbrook with a chance to convert on a three-point play. And the U.S. looking to get off to a much quicker start than they did in that first half, and actually playing a little bit of defense here, as Keshrit had no trouble, though, with it. The shot won't go. Ben Ramadan with the rebound. His shot won't go, and Kevin Love, the rebounding champion in the NBA, comes away with it. Deron Williams, and partially deflected by Mawa. So Williams once again will get to the free throw line. So look at El Mabrouk. Headed to play for the Brooklyn Nets. Played several years for the Utah Jazz. A lot of people in costume here. And I believe there's a lane violation, so they'll give him another free throw. Somebody stepped over the line early for Tunisia. And Williams takes advantage of the extra award. Keshrid ran it up against a little pressure. Nice pick, set him free. Tunisia runs a lot of pick and rolls. You'll see them come up high post and try to block off a man. And Alif Maua hasn't been shooting well, but he's not stopping the shot, that's for sure. Anthony. Carmelo Anthony, been around a while. This is his third Olympics. Again, he was on that team that lost a couple Olympics ago, snapped the U.S. streak. Tipped away from behind. That was Westbrook. Westbrook, easy one for Iguodala. And Adil Talatli doesn't like what he sees, quickly calls a timeout. So we'll take a break with the U.S. up 55-33. Some team statistics. The United States has made 22 of 37 shots, 59%. Tunisia's taken the same amount, 37, but they made just 12, so they're hitting 32%. Those 10 made baskets are the difference, as the United States is up by a little bit more than 20 at this point. Off to a good start, 9-0 run to begin this third quarter to try to create some space with a very surprising Tunisian squad that hung with them a lot longer than people thought they would. Of course, they're doing it without Salah Mejri, who's on the bench with those fouls. Mejri's now going to come in. He'll be wearing number 15. He stands 2 meters 16, and he is the center and the middle of the entire Tunisian basketball team. His goal is to play in the NBA. He's got some time. He's 26 years old. He's played in the NBA farm system as well as overseas. So just over 8 minutes left to play here in the third quarter. The U.S. on a 9-0 run. Tunisia trying to stop the bleeding a little bit. They could use a bucket here. And Love is fouled as he goes for the hoop. And if that's on Mejri, he wasn't in the game very long before picking up his fourth. Let's see. Now they're giving it to Erzig, so that'll be a very fortunate situation for Mejri. Hey, look, I'm on TV. Maybe I should have shaved. 55-33. 7:56 to go in the third. Kevin Love plays for Minnesota in the NBA, and he's going to get some company. A couple Russians, Kirilenko, and one of the youngest stars on that Russian team, Alexei Shved, have just signed to play with Minnesota and will be his teammates next year. Kirilenko's been around a long time, great scorer, the Russian rifle. They call him AK-47. He's had a red-hot Olympics leading Russia to two straight wins. Ten seconds on the shot clock. Nice pass to Ben Ramdan and a beautiful basket. His nickname's the Gladiator, and you can see why. He does not back down from anybody. Russell Westbrook trying to get some momentum to the hoop. And now Anthony with it. Never met a shot he didn't like. Melo played out of Syracuse University, got traded to the New York Knicks after a long career in Denver. Stop. Anthony, nice pass down low, gets the return pass for the basket, and the U.S. now with this group of players seems to really have gel. 14-2 is the start they've had in the first 3.5 minutes here of the third quarter. We're at the basketball arena at Olympic Park on a beautiful night here in London. And Hadi Dunn, a little bit slow trying to get through that gap. 1 second on the shot clock, so he threw a tire there, did Deron Williams. There goes the shoe. We'll see how good he is at retying a shoe under pressure. Can start the shot clock. A lot of sponsors' dollars on those shoes. So Hadi Dunn to the free throw line and just too strong. Still looking for his first points. He's been to the line. This will be his fourth try, still looking for one to go in. Williams is really trying to apply the pressure, get that fast break moving. Anthony for three, and he's on fire. He has 7 this quarter. The entire Tunisian team has 3. Erzic and Anthony with the rebound. Kevin Love left-handed. Now the U.S. really opening up that lead. 36-65 now. Love's had a lot of knee problems in his career. Got banged a little bit. And he's trying to walk it off a little bit, but that's making the fans of the Minnesota Timberwolves very nervous, because that's a multi-million dollar knee they don't want to mess with here. 65-36. United States now comfortably ahead in the third quarter. So Erzic will inbound with just under 6 minutes left to play here in quarter number 3. U.S. doing a much better job keeping Keshrid from running a lot of plays. Ben Ramdan looking to go one-on-one. And there's the foot speed and quickness. Westbrook jams it home. A big third quarter here for the United States. 21-3 they lead in this quarter. Now the fans beginning to wake up a little bit. And Anthony fouls Ben Ramdan. Just 2 seconds left on the shot clock at the moment. And there's a great finish there by Russell Westbrook. And Kevin Durant comes into the game. Durant played 1 year at the University of Texas before quickly turning pro and quickly rookie of the year in the NBA. And he's been shooting lights out. And the youngest player on the team is now seeing a little bit of action for the U.S. Anthony Davis, the 19-year-old, wearing number 14. He's a big one. And another long-range bomber goes. And the U.S. is just heating it up. Williams has really played well this quarter. It was 21-15 after the first quarter, just a six-point lead for the U.S. In fact, Tunisia led with like 4 minutes to go in that first quarter. And then the U.S. opened up a little bit of a lead at halftime. And this quarter, they've really separated. They've outscored Tunisia 23-3. Besides one field goal from Ben Ramdan and a free throw from Hadidon, that's been it. So Hadidon back to the free throw line where he's had some problems. And he misses two more. Chris Paul back at point guard for the U.S. And that's the youngster, Davis. Durant, the sharp shooting forward. And slam back in by the kid. Iguodala, one of the best young talents in the NBA. Scored a bucket. Makram Ben Ramdan, who else? He has been all the offense for Tunisia. Beautiful feed down low. He gets fouled and he'll get a free throw. And there's Iguodala's putback. Iguodala went to the University of Arizona. He was named the Sporting News 2006 Good Guy for his charitable work off the court. So Lagunesh is now in at point. Keshrad gets a rare break from the action. And a nice move to the hoop by Hadidon. It's much easier to make those than free throws. 30-point lead, 71-41, approaching 3 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Foul on Erzig. Kevin Durant decided to take it as himself and was almost to the hoop by the time he got grabbed. So Durant will go to the free throw line to shoot a couple. That's three for Amin Erzig. Erzig showed good range in the game against Nigeria at 18 points, hit a lot from the outside. Haven't seen him take many shots in this one. Durant now at 11 for the U.S. That's LeBron James still on the bench. He and Kobe Bryant have not played here in the second half. Four on one fast break. And that's the 19-year-old kid, Anthony Davis. And you can see why he was the number one pick out of the university level in the NBA draft this year. He grew so fast that when he started college, he was a guard and quickly is now almost 7 feet tall. Actually, I had him growing a little bit too fast. When he started high school, he was a guard. There's a look at the bearded one, James Harden. Iguodala will get a break, and LeBron James will see a little bit of action here. Comes in with just a couple minutes to play in the third quarter. Nineteen points for Ben Ramdan. Durant saves it, and that's usually automatic. Harden, one of the great outside shooters. It's been a big quarter for the Americans. Hadi Don left alone. A little bit too strong. Davis fights for it, loses control. And then the Gladiator took it away from him and gets fouled. Ben Ramdan still playing hard. His motor does not quit. There's a good job of how he used his left hand to shield the ball, and then the perfect shooting form of Harden. Don't you wish you could take a shot where the net barely moves like that? You can see what a good night he's had. Just over a minute still to play here in the third quarter. Kevin Durant will go to the hoop, and an alley-oop pass for Davis. That'll make the highlight reel. Hadi Don comes back for three. Well, Tunisia's got 14 points now on the quarter, which isn't bad for them, as James knocks down a three. The problem is that the United States has just racked up a whole bunch of points in this quarter. 34. With a chance to improve that. It's actually 37-14 that they've outscored him here in this quarter. So Chris Paul, 10 seconds left to go in the quarter. Very impressive third quarter. And another alley-oop slammer. And Anthony Davis is going to be on the cover of a lot of posters from those last couple shots. 85-47, an amazing third quarter. The U.S. wins the quarter 39-14 and has blown this game wide open. You can see the difference. The U.S. has hit 34 baskets. Tunisia's made only 17, and that's it. The Americans also, after throwing the ball away a lot early now with only 7 turnovers in the game. Some highlights from that third quarter, and you're going to see some ending, I'm sure, with Anthony Davis's great shots. Carmelo Anthony came out quickly and scored 9 points. For Tunisia, Ben Ramdan, he has been their offense. He and Hadi Don were the only ones that scored that quarter. And Anthony with this three-pointer. And then the fun starts. Westbrook with the jam. As Hadi Don's basket And now the lead alley-oop pass to Davis. And you see the bench react. Nice little montage, ended right at the end of the song. Leading scorers for the U.S., Anthony with 16, Ben Ramdan with 19 for Tunisia. Well, we thought the final score in this game could be something as bad as 120 to 50. And Tunisia played a very inspired first half to keep it reasonably close, but the U.S. just ignited a fire there in the third quarter. Outscored him by 25 in the third quarter. And we're underway here. Fourth quarter action. USA after blowing it open in the third quarter with a big comfortable lead over Tunisia. 85-47. The Americans look to be the only undefeated team at the end of day two from Group A. And it'd be a lot easier if you had the basketball going to the hoop. And the foul committed by Chris Paul. That was a good foul. That was an easy basket for Erzig. The U.S. started off very slowly. It was as if Kobe Bryant and LeBron James just didn't have any energy at all, didn't play any defense. And at the end of the first quarter, if you missed it, it was only 21-15, and Tunisia had a lead with a couple minutes to go in the first quarter. The second quarter, Coach Krzyzewski put in a different starting five, and they opened up a little bit of a lead. And then in the third quarter, he kept those same players on the court, and they just blew it open. Another alley-oop pass, and again, Anthony Davis. And this kid's going to think the game is that easy. They said it went off the knee of one of the Tunisian players, USA basketball. 87-48 the score. Paul in the corner, and that's Harden. Give him three more. And we're going to have a timeout called by Adil Talatli. Our score as we are just underway here in the fourth quarter. The United States 90, Tunisia 48. And these three clowns dressed up doing the YMCA dance, keeping themselves going here late in the game as the U.S. has started to blow this one wide open, leading 90-48 now. It's good to see Love standing up again after hurting his knee earlier. That's a very expensive knee. He's had some back injuries in his career. Kobe Bryant pointing toward the heavens. Bryant grew up really in Italy as his father, Jellybean Bryant, played overseas. Played 8 years in the NBA, but played a lot of time in Italy. Kobe respects the international game and is respected for it. He's fluent in Italian and English. Probably the only American player that is fluent in Italian. Cash rid off the screen from Mejri. And the U.S. has closed up that middle that was wide open early. Ben Ramadan will fire. And a shot clock violation leads to the turnover. if you just joined us, you look at the score and you think this one has been no contest from the beginning, and it really wasn't so. The U.S. came out so sluggish, it was actually trailing, and it's good to see Love back on the court. Durant chases down the missed shot and emphatically puts his name on the book. And Kevin Durant now with 13 points for the U.S. 8 minutes left to play in this one. Indonesia did much better in the first half when Keshred was playing the point from way outside and working off screens. We're not seeing that here in the second half. And Bin Ramadan still fighting, comes away with his missed shot. I think they're going to get him for an offensive foul. Seven and a half minutes left to play, and a very, very welcome reception at the bench for Bin Ramadan. What a game he's had. And he'll get a breather. Erzig back in. And Mejri with the easy rebound. Marwan Keshret, little playmaker. See if he can get the offense going for Tunisia. They've only scored 15 points in the second half. The United States has scored 46. That may be the last you see of Chris Paul tonight for Team USA. As Russell Westbrook comes off the bench to spell him. Not much of a drop-off between the first five and the next five. Hadi Dunn from way outside. And that won't fall, but a foul. You can tell Anthony Davis is going to be exciting when he gets to play in the NBA this next season. Again, has yet to play a game yet, just coming out of the university level. Look at him get up. They gave Hadi Dunn credit for a three-pointer on that last jump shot. So Davis, who didn't play at all in the first half, has 9 points now in the second half. As LeBron James looks on, as does Makram Bin Ramadan. And Davis, who scored 10 quick points, 8 of them on skywalking jammers, is going to get to break, and the starter, Tyson Chandler, will come back in. Keshred trying to set the offense, running off a back screen. U.S. defense playing much better in the second half. And a foul on Love. That'll be a good move by Alif Mawa. Now, the roster and the lineup has number 10 as Mawa. The jersey says Hafsi. It's number 10, but it says Hafsi. So if it is, that's Mehdi Hafsi, and he has scored 3 points and not Mawa. Good rebound by Mejri. Mawa Just under 6 minutes left to play in this one. It was close for most of the first half. And that's off the hands of Tyson Chandler, so Tunisia will get the ball back. There's 1 second on the shot clock. So they will have to get a shot off immediately after touching it. And the shot clock goes off, and the U.S. comes away with it. Williams for three. Darren Williams. And the U.S., which was off to a very slow start, is going to cross the century mark pretty soon here. So that was Hofsi. And we do have confirmation that they changed numbers and uniforms. And Kevin Love puts the missed shot back in. Marwan Keshred sets the offense. Everything that worked in the first half is not working now. And Mejri went for the impressive putback, but came up just about short, and I think he caught the hand of the U.S. player on the rim. That was Tyson Chandler. That's got to hurt. That's not where you want your hand behind, between the rim and another guy's slam. And Chandler's going to get some ice on that. It's one position the United States very thin here. Williams' shot won't go. And Mejri with another rebound. And in action, the United States now with 102 points as Love bangs it home. They've got a lot of players who can put points on the board quickly. Approaching 4 minutes left to play in this game. Now the score is what a lot of people might have expected, but the way they got here was a little bit different. Westbrook runs it across the timeline. And Williams this time won't take that shot. Zone defense being played now by Tunisia. Alley-oop to Love, and he doesn't have the same elevation as the youngster. And Westbrook couldn't get through that crease there. Just 3.5 left to go in this one. This one was put away in the third quarter when the United States outscored Tunisia 39-14. They have not needed Kobe Bryant in the second half. This is mop-up time, with about 3 minutes left to play, and Mejri finally hits the scoring column, emphatically. The NBA has kind of a training league called their D-League, and Mejri has played some in that league, as well as some other international ball. His goal is to get to the NBA, and with moves like that, the big seven-footer has a shot. James Harden back in for the U.S., number 12. And Chris Paul, a no-look pass under the basket, and the U.S. had nothing to do with it. And now they're just having a little fun. Anthony Davis with his fifth slam dunk. Keshrad looking for a cutter. You can see the U.S. much more interested in playing defense in the second half. Love to hear what Coach Krzyzewski had to say. Meshri hustles to keep the ball in Tunisia's hands. Nice move by Keshrad. He didn't take the shot. And they will not stop. Meshri again. They're behind by 44 points, and they're still going like it's a close game. It's good to see. A lot of heart in this Tunisian basketball team. Marwan Keshrad, the playmaker. And Meshri got a little overcomp. Love for three. And a quick break. And a little bit of a timeout called by the USA. They're on top 107-60 as you see the pass backwards between the legs from Iguodala to Love for the three-pointer. Not a lot of coaching you can do with a minute and a half down by 47. You need a 45-point play followed by a three-pointer. But Tlotli still diagramming plays, still trying to keep his players' minds in the game and off the scoreboard. The United States has 124 Olympic wins and just five losses. One of those losses was very painful a few years ago. The only loss by a dream team since they started having the NBA players. And Carmelo Anthony and LeBron James were on that team that lost. And their goal is not to be on another one that loses while they're still playing. The U.S. without Dwayne Wade, one of the great players in the NBA, without the center Dwight Howard, the other center Chris Bosh, and point guard Derrick Rose, who might have even been the starter on this team, all out with injuries, were unable to continue with Team USA, so they were replaced. And one of those replacements was 19-year-old Anthony Davis, number 14, who scored a dozen points on those dunks. And Ben Ramadan draws the foul, and what a game he's had. He's got 10 rebounds to go with those 19 points, as well as four assists. Very solid game. His only problem today has been making free throws. So he's now 3 of 8 from the line. Quick pass from Love to Harden. And Chris Paul will take the jumper. Under a minute left to go in this one. Who else? Makram Ben Ramadan, 22 now for the night. Paul working a little bit of the clock, and Love's had a hot hand. He has 15 in the second half, 17 for the game. Good to see that knee injury was just a quick stinger. And let's see if the U.S. even takes another shot. So that'll do it, the final score. The Americans with a huge second half blow out Tunisia as expected, 110-63. In the second half, the U.S., I just want to make sure I get this right, outscored them 64-30, and that's what turned the tide. Final score, 110-63. Little quick wrap-up for the United States. Both Kevin Love and Carmelo Anthony finished officially with 16 points. Kevin Durant, 13. Westbrook, 11. Anthony Davis off the bench, 5 of 5 for 12 points. By the way, Anthony didn't miss either. U.S. shot a phenomenal 61% in this game. For Tunisia, they were a one-man show. Ben Ramadan, 22 points, 11 rebounds, 4 assists, a steal, and a block shot. But he couldn't do it alone, and the United States has too much firepower and takes off, knocking off Tunisia. Final score once again from the arena here at Olympic Park. The USA 110, Tunisia 63.